Hey, Ethan.
Hi there.
Thanks so much for talking with us today about what it's like to be a med school student.
Yeah, my pleasure.
So let's get started.
Sure.
Did you always want to be a doctor?
I did not always want to be a doctor. It was something that I thought about when I was really, really young, but through my kind of high school and undergrad, I really didn't want to be a doctor. I tried to do all these other things and figure out anything else I liked, but all paths kind of kept leading me here, and now I couldn't be happier.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how hard is med school in your experience?
Yeah, in some ways it's a 1, and in others it's a 10. I think people are always very scared of how much you have to learn and how hard the material is. But honestly, that is not the most challenging part. I think what becomes really, really challenging is waking up every day, going to school every day, and continually staying committed and engaged to your learning, knowing that, you know, you're only 1 year in or 2 years in, and you still have so many years to go. I think that's the challenging part, is just staying committed.
What's an important skill you need to be successful in med school?
Yeah, I think one of the most important things that I've been able to bring to med school and that's given me a lot of success is knowing how to prioritize. You know, when you're there, you're given so much material, so many different tasks. There's 100 different parts of the curriculum that seem really overwhelming when you're just presented all of it at the very outset. But I think figuring out, you know, there's these three things that I need to do today and this that I need to do tomorrow. And this one doesn't really matter that much. I can probably put that to the side. That's probably the most important thing that I've brought into med school, is just being able to critically appraise the material and then know what really matters.
Best thing about med school so far?
I love how many moving parts there is. It's a really, really dynamic curriculum, and every day is a little bit different. I think that's super fun, keeps you on your toes.
What's something you should think seriously about before deciding to apply to med school?
That's a great question. I think as kids and in high school, you're always told it's like engineer, doctor, lawyer, you know, accountant. Those are the things that you can do. That's what makes a successful career. That is so not true. I think you need to really ask yourself if medicine, and really do some research about what doctors do every day, if that's where your skills and your passions and your interests are best sort of suited. Because I think we can become very siloed into these big sort of three professions, and there's so much out there. There's such a big world, and I think that's really important to explore before kind of making that commitment to med school.
Most important thing you learned in kinesiology is?
I think having a very strong anatomy foundation has been very helpful to sort of continue building up on the medical knowledge. And UW-Kin was amazing for that. So I'd say that's one of the biggest, like, kind of material content aspects that I brought into med ed. Yeah.
One tip for students who want to get into med school.
Do what you love. Don't do what you think admissions committees want you to do. Actually do what you're passionate about and be honest with the things that you care about, because that comes across way, way more in any application, in any interview. When you speak about what you care about and why you're doing it, that comes across so much more than just getting the hours in at a clinic that you think that you should volunteer at. Really just do what you love.
And that's it, Ethan. Thank you so much.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks so much.